Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I've done a couple things off camera before starting the recording. I tried to upgrade my S-Stock to plus 4, and unfortunately I still can't, because I need, I think it's large Titanite shards. I need 2 of those, and I have absolutely 0. I'm really surprised I haven't gotten a single one, but hopefully I'll find some soon. The other thing I did is I used my storage box, which you can access by going to a bonfire. And I use that to store most of my extra stuff. So I used it to store all of the weapons that I'm not using. So everything but the S-Stock and the Halberd. Also most of the bows and every piece of armor that I'm also not wearing. So it's gonna make it... Oh, and also the shields, by the way. It's gonna make it a lot easier to look through my inventory when I'm trying to search for something that I've picked up. Alright, let's go through the doors that I've just opened. I feel like this is going to lead to a boss fight. It feels like boss fight time, because it's been quite a while since I fought a boss. Well, not a boss quite yet. Look at all these candles and swords. Feels very ceremonial. Secrets? No secrets. Wasn't quite on the right level to backstab it, but that's fine. This is suspicious. There's like this little raised area here, and there's nothing on it. It's very suspicious. I wonder if maybe you can fall down from up there. Let's get a good stab in here. Oh, they're not even paying attention to me. They're worshipping. Worshipping what? The tree? I'm surprised how often I miss with this strong attack. I think it's because it hits mainly from the right, so you actually kind of want to be to the left of the enemy. Like, if I wanted to hit the tree, I probably wouldn't want to attack it like this, I'd probably want to attack it more like this. Goes back down into the swamp. God, those things are creepy. I hope they can't jump up here. I used to think they were cute. Oh, what's going on up here? It's a fight between what and what? Uh-oh. Oh, good. Thank God. Please kill that thing. That's one of those really hard nights, I think. Yes, it's dead. Bonfire ahead. Now the real fight begins. Phantom. Hmm? Did you see how the light just changed? What the? Look at the reflections off the ground. What is going on? I think it's like, I don't know, like a fog or some sort of environmental effect that's being blended between when you go inside versus outside. It's very odd. Of course there's nothing here. Okay, before I explore in there, I think I saw a pathway around the side of this building. There's gotta be something back here, right? Aw, there's nothing. Nothing but disappointment. Disappointment in the shape of a vacuum. Not like the kind you plug in and use to suck up dirt. You know, vacuum, like the lack of something, because I didn't find anything. Okay, how did that miss? I specifically went to the left before doing that attack. How does it keep missing? It does attack more to the right. It also kind of hits the feet. I guess it aims down. Is that the problem? Okay, so where should I go first? Over this way or towards the bonfire? I'm gonna go this way first. Dark leggings. Significantly heavier. A bit better physical protection. Eh. I don't think it's worth the weight increase. Okay, let's try strong attack again. That one hit. Oh no, not these ones. They have such range. Okay, I can handle one. This looks like a boss room. I hear the sounds of battle from within. Try rolling. Would there be counterattack? If only I had a friend. Be wary of fire. Hmm? Oh, yes. Yes, yes, that certainly looks like a boss room. Shall I go there now? Nah, let's save that for later. Yeah, when I peeked inside there, I think I saw a bunch of corpses. And given the sounds I'm hearing, I'm guessing there was a great battle there. And the boss that I'm probably gonna fight probably defeated all those people. I feel like I'm gonna fight a tree creature at some point. Although I guess I already have the cursed rotted greatwood. Okay, so this pathway is completely explored except for the boss room. So you know what? What the heck? Let's go fight the boss, it's been a while. Now, what did they say? Try rolling, be wary of fire. Try rolling, let there be counterattack. I can't do counterattacks, unfortunately. Actually, can you do counterattacks if you do this block? I don't know, I never use that. Nah, who cares, I'm just gonna roll. Okay, be wary of fire and roll. Did they just kill their twin? Looked exactly like them. This looks like an agility kind of boss. I'm guessing fast attacks, fast movement. Oh god. Here we go. Let's see who's faster. Abyss Watchers, yes. Yes, I do. Okay. Do they both have the same attacks? No? Are there gonna be more Watchers? That one died strangely easily. What is going on? I don't understand why there's so many enemies. That was an accidental backstep. Ooh! Please fight each other. Okay, there's the phantom. Yes, distract him. Wait, no, don't attack me! What's happening? I don't understand. As far as I can tell, it looks like there's a main enemy that I need to defeat, and that's considered the boss. And then there's also, like, an ad that has very little health that will try to attack me. And then there's also another ad that has the glowing red eyes, and it seems like that one attacks the boss and distracts it, but also attacks me or something? I don't know. I'm not exactly sure. Oh, that looked funny. Okay. Please go after the other one. No, it's coming after me. Okay, so it comes after me, but the boss goes after it. I've been drinking way too many flasks. Okay, it's almost dead. Was that it? Well, that was exceptionally easy. That was not it. This is the beware of fire part, isn't it?
And I have no Estus left.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.
Okay. Jesus Christ. Do I still have my ring on that protects against fire? Yeah, increases fire damage absorption. Whew, alright. I'm still debating with myself whether I should keep trying it or just go the other way for now. I don't know. Let's see if this way is maybe a cleaner way to go than the other way. Oh yeah, that's way better.
Oh
backstab in.
Oh!
I don't even know what happened there. It's just a tornado of death. Wait, what's the right way? This way. After a couple more attempts, I think I'm going to start using an ember to up my health. I'm pretty good at fighting the first incarnation of the boss, but I don't have enough experience with the second one to feel comfortable using an ember. Didn't watch my health enough. Caught me off guard. Okay, let's not keep my back to the center of the room this time.
No! Let me out! I'm stuck! Fuck!
Okay, I'm thinking when the ad spawns, I should probably take it out right away. Don't try to ignore it and just go for the boss. Because it's pretty easy to take out. It seems like when the ad is attacking you, the boss pays a little bit less attention to you and kind of keeps its distance. Plus, the ad is very easy to just stun lock. Got hit with every single attack in that combo. Jesus Christ, I'm doing terrible. Okay. Come on, they were one hit away from dying. Okay, but yeah, definitely focusing on the ad as soon as it pops up is a very good idea. Fight each other. Come on. There we go. No, don't fight me. Okay. Here we go. Let's just skip that if I can. Okay. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. I'm scared! Not too hard, actually. It's got some crazy attacks, and they're pretty hard to dodge, but it's relatively easy to stun it and interrupt its attacks, so I feel comfortable taking the Ember now. Let's take an Ember, and I'm also gonna take a damage increase as well. Let's see. Oops. Let's dump those. Don't need them. What should I use against it? Oh, temporarily boosts fire damage absorption. I should probably use those, too. Yeah, let's put those in, as well as a damage increase. Using fire against it is probably a terrible idea. I'm sure it's resistant to it. Lightning? Dark? Poison? Hmm. Well, it's wearing armor, so let's go with lightning. Oh no. Are you a person or AI? I think you're a person. Now I wish I didn't take that ember. Okay. I've come to loathe all fights with other players. 'Cause no matter what, it's either very laggy or a little bit laggy, and even a little bit laggy is enough to make any fight unfun. Because this game is all about timing, and when it's laggy, timing no longer works. You dodge at the right time, and suddenly it's the wrong time. It's really a shame. It just doesn't work with Dark Souls combat, I think. Okay, so I've got lightning damage and fire damage absorption. I'm not gonna use that until the second phase. Any of those. Wakey wakey, Phantom. There it is. It's coming up. No, don't hit me! Don't hit me! I'm innocent. Uh-oh, add back. Skip this, so let's hope before I can use my item before I die. Okay, very good place to be. Did I use it? I don't even know if I freaking used it. I'm not even gonna wait to check. I don't feel comfortable using items. Why do they always try to run out of the room when the fight ends? It's like, now's my chance, make a break for it! It says temporarily increases fire damage absorption. You know what, maybe it's long enough to last the whole fight. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna use it right outside the boss door. Fuck you, dick. Okay, this is a problem. Well, shit. rip my flasks. I kind of want to just start over. Nah, it's fine. Let's do this. Come on. This fight's really confusing. For a while, I thought it was the Phantom that was left alive at the end there. But no, in that battle between the three different versions of the Watchkeeper, or the Abyss Watchers or whatever, the Phantom actually died. Okay, no more embers. Forget it. Honestly, it doesn't feel like the embers or any of the things I took or even the lightning that I applied to my weapon did anything. It didn't feel like I was doing even slightly more damage. Universe. It's strange. Seems like I've hit a plateau on this boss. It feels like I'm not getting any better. Perhaps I should go the other way and search for more things to upgrade my armor and my weapons, and gain more levels. But nah, I can do this. I almost did it before. I can do it again. Come on, fight each other.
No! What the?
I knew it was coming, I just didn't think it would do enough damage to kill me in one hit. I just gotta keep trying it. You little... Okay, that's an important lesson for the future. I have a tendency where if an enemy is at like one hit point, as that one was, I just mash attack even though I'm constantly being stunned. Thinking, oh, I'll get a hit in and, you know, I just need to get one little hit in and the attacks will stop. But the problem is, that doesn't always work, as in that case. I kept trying to attack, but I couldn't because I was constantly stunned. Instead, I should have dodged. Haha, dodged that one. Now I know that the strong whatever attack you want to call that cannot be interrupted by a single poke. Come on, friend, wake up! Wake up, Phantom! There we go. Here we go. What? View? Please? Thanks. Jesus Christ, what was it doing? Alright. I took the red bug pellet. Good. Oh, not dead yet! Usually I manage to defeat a boss in one episode, but I'm not sure if I can do it this time. I'll give it a couple more tries. This is really frustrating. My first backstab, fuck you. Attack me, I'm your friend! Too busy here. I'm moving away. Yeah, fuck him up. Okay. All right, here we go. Oh, Jesus, come on. Seriously? Thank you.
Storm attack, bad idea.
Oh, that was going pretty well, actually. All right, one more try. I'm definitely getting better at dodging the fire version of it, though. Definitely much better. For once in my life, when I say, that's my last try, that's actually my last try. Oh, alright, Dark Souls 3. Today you win. Just so I can make some progress today. Just so I can feel useful. Okay. Hole. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to make some more attempts on the Abyss Watchers.